tragics across the country, Sunday was a holy day when Rachin Ravindra scored his maiden test century. But the best was yet to come, with the rising star doubling his efforts on Monday, putting the Black Caps in the driving seat to beat South Africa. The man himself joins us this morning from the Mount. Morena Rachin. Hey, congratulations. Morning. You have been described as an absolute phenomenon, I will clarify, by my husband. So how are you feeling about your efforts?
Thanks for having me. I wouldn't call myself a phenomenon just yet. I think there's a long way to go for that. But it was obviously a great day for us yesterday, not just individually for me, but as a team, and to have them sort of fall down and in a pretty good position for us is pretty cool.
Yeah, totally. Can we cast back to Sunday? You're out there with Kane Williamson when he gets his 30th test century. Moments later, you're getting your first test century. That must have felt like a pretty special moment.
Yeah, I sort of mentioned it in a little bit of the sort of chat after the game. And I mean, idolising Kane growing up and being able to share the crease with him is amazing. And I mean, that man's got 30 test hundreds and 90-odd test matches, which to me is phenomenal, you know, and that's unfathomable sometimes. So, I mean, being able to see the way he goes about his business from, you know, his processes and how, you know, dogged he is with his game plan and the way he's done it for the better part of 15 years is a testament to, you know, his hard work and his resilience.
That's very nice, but you've just talked all about Kane Williamson and not about yourself. So you were only halfway through on Sunday night. Did you get much sleep on Sunday night?
Yeah, I actually am a relatively good sleeper. I don't know why. I think it probably would have been a different story if I was on 99, but I guess the marathon passed, but I was just chilling.
So you get to Monday, you end up doubling it plus a bit more, we should add. Did that ever cross your mind that this would be the situation you'd be facing? 240, it's outstanding.
Yeah, not necessarily. I guess I was just trying to not look too far ahead and sort of take it ball by ball when you're out there. And I think having the guys around me, like sort of batted a bit of time with Daz and GP, both, you know, very good players, very aggressive players, so I could just kind of go out and do my thing and not worry too much about sort of ticking over the scoreboard and stuff, because naturally that'll happen. So I guess I was just trying to execute my plan over a long period of time.
You seem remarkably relaxed for someone who is a very high achiever at a very high level, with all eyes on you at the moment. Hey, Nat, speaking of all eyes, there's been a bit of social media content, obviously, as there is about sports stars these days, but I've seen a video of you taking your bats in to a specialist bat guy, and I want to know if you scored your centuries off this bat that went in.
I actually did. I took it to Peter Grace in Wellington. He's a great man, sort of looks after a lot of guys on the circuit's bats. And the bat I'm using it currently, the one I used yesterday, I wasn't too happy with the handle or something, and he shaped it nicely, so it ended up working out well. So thanks, Peter.
So are you going to keep the bat now? Is it a lucky charm, or are you going to have to retire it?
No, I won't retire it just yet. I think hopefully it's got a lot more innings in it. Hopefully it's got more runs in it, but let's see.
Yeah, well, hopefully it has got more in it. Have you got sort of like a plan here at 24? Do you think this is what I want to achieve? Are you looking to try and beat Kane Williamson's records at some point?
Nah, nothing like that. I think that man, he's achieved everything there is, and I think it's still a very, very, very long way away. So, nah, I'm not necessarily, I don't necessarily do it for that sort of individual accolades and all that sort of stuff and stats. I think if we can drive the team forward, I mean, that's the whole team environment and the reason why Black Caps have been so good over a period of time. If I can just contribute to driving the team forward in that moment, hopefully it'll keep me in good stead. And I mean, I try to keep it day by day, you know. Not, it's always nice when you look forward and, oh, I could be this, could be that, but I think if we can all look to be in the moment and whatever happens will happen.
Well, I'd say thanks to your efforts, they're in a very nice position at the moment. Hey, Rachin, last question. We have had a bit of debate about this in the last couple of days, about your name and whether you were in fact named after two great cricket players. I know your dad was a cricket player, but we've got to know the truth of the matter. Were you named after two great cricket players and your name combined into one?
Yeah, so the story is, yes, I am. Sort of, there was an article that went out when some dad did an interview, and I think they misquoted him a little bit on that. So it is true. But the whole thing is, we don't necessarily talk about it that much anymore. It was just, you know, at the time it was like, oh yeah, cool, this, you know, this is cool, and now it sort of turned out that way. But yeah, the story goes that I was named after Rahul and Sachin. Yeah.
We don't have to talk about that story anymore. We've got a new one, and it's Rachin Ravindra, and he has scored 240 in this latest test match against South Africa. Congratulations. Thank you so much for your time this morning. Hey, and all the best. It's not over yet.
That's the name, isn't it? Remember the name.
It is. Morena Pete, you are the mastercraft of lucky bats, it seems.
Good morning, Anna. Yeah, nice words from Rachin there. He's a top man with some top skills. So, yeah, happy to be a little bit of a part of it, maybe 1%. But he's doing some fantastic stage on the world stuff on the world stage. So super happy for him.
Pete, I've had a look back through the notes that our producers have put in here, and I'm fascinated because you are neither a cricketer nor was this your day job until recently.
No, that's right. So I was a golfer. Yeah, I guess like with golf, things are pretty precise. You're working with metal and things like that. So when you're getting fitted for golf clubs, you can be pretty precise. Whereas with a cricket bat, it's a piece of wood. No two pieces of wood are the same. And I found that a super good challenge to try and match up some of these bats and try and understand why some people may have 20 bats and why one of them's their favourite. So really enjoy it. Yeah, it's fantastic now. It is my day job now.
You used to be a fireman, didn't you? Did you have to learn any new skills to craft the perfect black cat bat?
Yeah, absolutely. So I was a fireman. I was a fireman for 9 years, and it was a fantastic job, and it gave me a little bit of spare time on the side to sort of like get into a hobby. And that's how it started out. It started out as a hobby. And then moved into pretty quickly taking it quite seriously and trying to understand how these top players do what they do, and really wanted to be a part of that.
Now, business is doing quite well for you, largely through word of mouth, but you have some big names on the books. Can you drop any for us? We know Rachin.
Rachin, yeah, I mean... pretty much all the local guys, the local first-class team, the Firebirds and the Blaze, they've just been massive supporters, as I am of them. Who we got? Michael Bracewell, done a bit of work for Kane Williamson, Tom Blundell. Pretty much probably three-quarters of the Black Caps. They're just such a pleasure to work with.
That's a pretty impressive record. And now, so someone just brings you a bat, and what do they say to you? I obviously do not play cricket. I want to hit it a certain way. Or how do you guys talk through what that feels like for a player and what they want the end result to be?
Yeah, so pretty much you become a cricketer, and your job is to entertain. So for batsmen, the way to entertain is to score cricket, to score runs. Typically what we do with the top players is their sponsors send them pretty good bats. English Willow's a bit like, I guess the analogy would be like having a cow. There's like fillet steak, rump steak, chuck steak within the tree. Sorry vegetarians, but it's sort of like the analogy I'd use. But the top players get the creme de la creme. It's a bit like fillet steak with caviar on top. And then just trying to get those extra 1%ers. So I guess the main thing is what they're after is comfort-wise. So comfort brings confidence and performance. So we start with the only part that you touch on the bat, which is the handle. So we're really into getting these matched up exactly how they like them. And then it's also, you'll hear a lot of talk about cricket bat balance. So I guess a lot of people think that players want really light bats. It's not necessarily true. What they need is a bat that is heavy enough to go the distance if they decide to try and hit a six. So it's about balance. So the best way to do it would be to, and the most skillful bat makers in the world would sort of give someone a bat that is balanced to feel lighter than what it actually is, but just with science and physics, if you have more mass behind a ball, so 2 pounds, 9 ounces, sorry for getting technical, but that's kind of like the magic number.
You might have lost me.
So if you've got a bat, 2 pounds, 9 ounces, that's sort of like between that 2.9 and 2.10, that's what the pros are after. If you can make a bat that's 2.11 that feels 2.9, I guess Daryl Mitchell would be like an example of that. His bats are slightly heavier than what they feel. But then it enhances that beautiful shot that he plays back over the umpire's head for six. So it's sort of, the more wood you have behind the ball, the better. So
yeah. Pete Grace, he's the caviar of cricket bats. Thank you so much for showing us around this morning.
Thanks, Anna.